vår havstid og forvilles. Slik til deg tid på hva det er vi. Kom, ja. Amen. Anybody is ready to walk into a promise? Will you hear and read the scripture with me today? Stand. Others who can also receive your blessings seated. But there's a gift in fearing God. Came out of the Sunday school lesson today. Don't do it because of political pressure. Do it because your heart is ready to hear God. Hebrews, the 6th chapter, verses, 2 verses there, 17 and 18. God also bound himself with an oath, so that those he promised, let me use a promise.
Promise
to help. Would be perfectly sure and never need to wonder whether he might change his plans. Verse 18. He has given us both his promise and his oath. Two things we can completely count on. For it is impossible for God to tell a lie. Now, all those who flee to him to save them can take a new courage when they hear such assurance from God. Now, they can know without doubt that he will give them the salvation he has promised to them. And that is the truth with your name on it. Shout amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. I want to read it one more time. Hebrews 6, verse 17 and 18. God also bound himself with an oath. It's interesting how most of us want to remain free, but God is bound to you. God is engaged and he is committed to you. Lord, bless me in these moments. If somebody pray for the preacher, let me know I'm not alone in telling the truth. Not alone in telling the truth. And if God is committed to us, how much more should we be committed to him? This here is a promise. And I need to tie a knot around my ankle, my left. I need to tie a knot around my right ankle. I need to tie a tight bracelet on my wrist. I may even be willing, my brothers and sisters, to voluntarily put a yoke around my neck. And these are the words that I will have engraved upon these marks. Amen. He has given me both a promise,
hallelujah,
and an oath. Two things he's given me. Amen. That I can completely count on. That it's impossible for God to lie. Now for those who flee, and this is where I'm going to run for just a good 7 minutes. Can I have 7 minutes to heaven?
Amen.
Would you stay with me?
Amen.
For those who flee to God, I'm going to stay on that path, right there. For those who flee to him to save them, amen, can take new courage, encourage my soul, and let us journey on. Can take a new courage. When they hear the assurance from God, I'm glad to know, amen, that it's not me you're listening to right now. And God uses me. And I'm not the only one God used. God uses you.
Amen.
He speaks still from eternity. Have no doubt, he said. Salvation, I promised you. I will deliver you. Those who have fled for refuge. I want to talk for the 6.5 minutes left with me from the subject, Castle Jesus. Fleeing for refuge. See, Moses established 6 cities. How many?
Six cities
of refuge. 3 were on the east side of the River Jordan, and 3 was on the west. And when a man had killed anyone accidentally, he fled to one of these cities. 6 cities of refuge. 3 on this side, 3 on that side of the river. The roads leading to them were kept perfectly good, so that when a man started for the refuge, nothing might stop him. Can y'all hear me out there?
Amen.
Along the crossroads, and wherever there might be any mistake about the way, there were signs putting up, pointing in the right way, with the words, refuge. And having gained the limit of one of these cities, the man was safe, and the mothers of the priests provided for him. Maybe that's what we're imitating when we have the mothers of the church, the pastor of the church. When people are coming for refuge. And some of us, if we would just learn to really testify and stop testifying, are fleeing from trouble.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Sister Sarah. We're fleeing from problems both within and without. I remember when you were doing a series of preaching, when God was giving you allowance that was helping us to recognize that most of us are looking for problems and fights with people on the outside of us, and we won't admit that we're in the worst fight of our life with ourselves.
Amen.
In our mind, we're having a fight. In our spirit, we're in war. We're just not at peace, and we're looking for a safe place to hide. Where you gonna run when the world's on fire? Where are you really gonna hide? Just give me 6 more minutes. Take a nap this afternoon. When there be no more rock to lay your head. Some of us have been seeing our perils, but I'm glad that I'm not alone in this church today. And I wish I'd get an amen that would have occupied the point that somebody here has fled to Christ.
Amen.
You have been through hard times. You've been through being left alone. You've been through being lied on. You've been through sin. You've been through heartache. And you tried everything. I searched all over. I just couldn't find anybody. Christ is represented in the Bible as a tower, a high rock, a fortress, and a shelter. And if you have seen any of these ancient castles of Europe, amen, I hope one day I get a chance, granddad, to get on over to Europe, amen. You know that you're surrounded by trenches. I just want to let you know today that Jesus can be your castle.
Yes.
If you would just hide to Jesus. For those who are sick, for those who are needy, thank you, Sister Seed, for singing that song. And as you minister, you let us know that the power is in the word. And sometimes God will send a heavenly dove down from above to hide us in the castle of Jesus. I even had this week had to pray and had to thank God as I prayed and asked others to forgive me for harsh words that I said to them, because they had to remind me that, Reverend, this is a time of war. Satan seeks to devour anybody who stands up on the truth. Well, the devil may have a mark on my head. Jesus says, don't you worry about any threat that the devil has. You got to hide in Castle Jesus.
Amen.
can stop any threat.
Amen.
He can stop any enemy. He can stop you from being discouraged. Can I have a witness this morning? I just want to remind you today in closing that Jesus can be your castle. He will not only just be your castle, but I want to say this one more time, that he is the door. You know one thing about it, you can't get into Jesus, amen, climbing in through the window.
All right, all right.
Some people want to get in. Y'all know how we used to do when we wanted to get in the movie for free? You want to get the hookup?
Oh, why y'all get quiet?
I get relevant, then they get quiet. I don't know what to do sometimes, you know? We want somebody to just let me in because of who I am, or because of, you know my sister, or you know my brother, or you know, come on here. And if you just let me in, and Jesus said, you know, my kingdom can't run like that. Because if I run my kingdom like that, I let the right ones in, I let the wrong ones in, I let the good ones in, I let the bad ones in, and I wouldn't know who to trust. Because nobody's willing to pay their fare. But one thing about Castle Jesus, unlike all those 175 tickets and dollars we have to pay for tickets, y'all, all them letters she wrote, thank you for reading this, helping my sermon today. Amen. Because there's no fee in coming into Jesus' castle.
Right.
The only thing he asked and the only rule is, my brother, you got to come in by the door.
Yeah.
Don't come in the back door.
Yeah.
Coming in at night so nobody can see. Nicodemus had a problem
like
that. He said, Jesus, you know, I came here, but I want to come here at 11:50. Between 11:50, amen, at night and 12 midnight, because everybody's asleep. And I just want to ask you one question. What must I do to be saved?
All right.
When Jesus gave him his answer, he didn't like it. He said, well, I'll try you at 6 a.m. Yeah. Maybe you'll change your answer.
Yeah.
God doesn't change.
No.
You got to come in by the door. And if you come in by the door, he'll give you safety.
Yes.
Did anybody here who had admit that we live in a dangerous world?
Yes.
Amen. We live in a dangerous world. There's not always a dangerous world because of bad people. I have a story that will illustrate this as I close. Maybe this is that type of city that Donald Trump is thinking about. Got your attention, I don't. Perfect city, he's thinking about. He's thinking about a perfect nation. Where, amen, there'll be no crime there. There'll be nobody that shouldn't be there. Amen. All the right people will be in the town. It was told that some years ago, amen, so many years ago, they actually have started models of this type of city. And they prepared themselves, and only the right type, whatever that is, was in that city. No worry for any of that other stuff that happened in New York, and Chicago, and Detroit, amen, all those places. We don't even need an alarm system. We don't need a police officer. Everything is perfect. That morning, that man, when he thought he moved, amen, from his world to this new Jerusalem, this new Canaan, he walked out of his house with his slippers on and his bathrobe to pick up his paper. The welcome wagon that was running down the street that waves in the morning ran him over by accident. For the first time on the front page of that city on the next day, it said man killed and ran over by the welcome wagon. That's a little bit over your head. Like Johnny Carson would say, if you missed the joke. It's not a joke. Some things in life are meant to happen. Some accidents are meant to happen. You cannot safe way your way out of them. But I got news as I close today, if somebody would just give me a witness. You can safe way your way through it. Jesus can guide you through it. He can bring you through it. You may not know what your next step is, what your next issue is, but with Jesus, I can face what I don't know. With Jesus, I can face tomorrow. With Jesus, I can face my danger. With Jesus, I can face the new day. With Jesus, I can face the new moment. With Jesus, I can face the new day. Say it, be with me, walk with me, talk with me, share with me. Can I get it?